Good morning. Today we are going to learn about a select statement in SQL Server. So the select statement is used to display the particular field. Particular field is nothing but column or a table, whatever it may be, the which are there in the table. So suppose in the eSalary we have a salary details of all the employees. ENAME field gives the all the employee names. And this particular one, first record consisting of e-name, e-salary, age, male, gender, department. So this distinct is used to display the different values in the column. So today we are going to learn about these two, select statement as well as the distinct statement. So the syntax for the select statement, so as already I told you that it can be used to display the particular field in the table. So suppose here we have a syntax. So select is the keyword, then we need to apply the column number 1, 2, 3, how many columns are there. We need to give the column name. Suppose if you want to display only single column name, you just write a single column name here. Then from is the keyword, then after we are going to give the table name which we are going to display. Okay, right, this is a syntax for a select statement. Suppose distinct statement, this distinct statement, select statement, distinct statement is used to select only distinct values from our columns. Select distinct statement is used to display only distinct values in the column. So I will explain whenever I was executed the same code in our SQL server. As of now, you just remember that it is going to display the distinct values. So here the syntax for the distinct statement is that select distinct, it is a keyword, then we need to give the column number 1, column number 2, column number 3, or column name, then from is a keyword, then we need to give the table name which we are going to display. Okay, this is a syntax for select statement as well as a distinct statement. So now I'm going to execute the same query in our SQL server. Okay, this is my SQL server. Here I have a database that is Maresh. In this Maresh database, I have a table name called as a EMP123, consisting of 3 columns: employee ID, employee name, and employee salary. Here, suppose if I want to display the same table here, means I'm going to use the select statement. Select, then followed by star, from table name is EMP123. Once we execute this query, it is going to display the entire table. So this entire table consisting of 3 columns and each 2 records. So first record is employee ID 100 and its name is XXY and its salary is 3000. Second record is employee ID is 101 and its name is ABC and its salary is 35,000. So these are my records. Suppose if I want to display only this employee ID column. So for that, I'm going to use the select statement. Select. Here we need to give the column name. My column name is EID from is a keyword. Then which table I am going to display? Employee 123. So from this table, it is going to display this particular column only. So let me execute the same query. See here, I have selected employee ID column so that it is going to display the all the records in the employee ID column. So next, suppose if you want to display employee salary also along with employee ID, so ESL sal. My column name is ESL. So now I execute this one. So I got employee ID, employee salary. Suppose along with these two, I'm going to display one more column that is called ename. Employee name. So it is going to display 3 columns. Yes. Okay. Right. So now we have one more statement, that is a distinct statement. Distinct statement. So that one also I'm going to display now. my distinct statement syntax is select distinct distinct is the keyword. Next, we need to supply the that is a salary esal from table is emp 123. So it's going to display the distinct values in salary column. So here we have only two different values, that is 30,000 and 35,000. Suppose if I insert one more column, so insert into table name is EMP 123 values. So it has three values. Employee ID is 103 and employee name is AAB. Right? Should it is a string now? You need to give it in quotes. AAB. Then I'm going to give the employee salary is again same 30,000. See here. So now this record is one row is affected. Now I am going to display the column, all the columns in the table. So it has three columns and three records are there. So these two records are same. But in our distinct statement is going to display the distinct values, different values. So these two records are same, so that it doesn't display these two records. It is going to display only one record. Let me execute this one. See here, two different values, 30,000 and 35,000. Okay. This is about a distinct statement and a select statement in our SQL server.